Next topic is ferrocement. So this is some example for the ferrocement. You can see that, okay, for having some thin structures, you can see that after the reinforcement, and they are added again the mesh over here to make the surface with very thin, and making with the thin structure itself making a high strength. That is the main aim of the ferrocement. This is a type of thin reinforced concrete constructed of cement mortar reinforced with closely spaced layers of continuous and small diameter wire mesh. In the previous photo itself, you can see that I mentioned that a wire mesh to be added over the existing reinforcement, so that can be used for making the structure very thin, with the thin itself attaining the maximum strength. And the wire mesh also very closely spaced layers, so that the spacing between the two meshes along both the direction will be in types of say example 1 to 1 or 2 centimeter, depends on that. It is all well known that conventional reinforced concrete members are too heavy, brittle, which cannot be satisfactorily repaired if damaged, develop cracks, and reinforcement are liable to be corroded. So normal types of concrete structure, we know that the beams normally 230 by 300 mm, even some cases columns lead to 300 by 300 mm, and even if it fails also, the repairing work will not be get more satisfactory, and the cracks will also not get arrested repeatedly, the cracks will start develops, and the reinforcements also started to corrode. So in the instead of that going, so we can adapt the ferrocement concrete conditions. These disadvantages of normal concrete make it inefficient for certain types of work. Ferrocement is a relatively new material, consists of wire meshes and cement mortar. That is the main thing is noted here, is only with the cement mortar, not the concrete work. It consists of a closely spaced wire meshes which are impregnated with rich cement mortar mix. So with the mortar mix itself, we can adapt the more strength. The wire mesh is usually 0.5 mm to 1 mm dia wire at 5 mm to 10 mm spacing. I earlier said that 1 or 2 cm spacing. So it depends on the wire mesh. The spacing may be reduced. So here it has been defined as 5 mm to 10 mm spacing. And cement mortar is of cement sand ratio 1:2 or 1:3 with water cement ratio of 0.4 to 0.45. So that the cement quantity used here will be slightly higher. The ferrocement elements are usually of order 2 to 3 cm in thickness with 2 to 5 mm external cover to the reinforcement. So you know that elements of size 2 to 3 cm in thickness with 2 to 5 mm external cover. Normally we adopt cover size of 20 mm on the outer side, whereas here the cover is only 2 to 5 mm. So the thickness is also 2 to 3 cm only, the ferrocement element thickness. The steel content varying between 300 kg to 500 kg per cubic meter of mortar, depends on the mortar mix ratio and strength factors. The steel content ratio will get varied from 300 kg to 500 kg. So these are some examples for the ferrocement construction. A normal dome structure, semicircular, this is a quarter circular structure. And this is the ferrocement for that we are adapted the mesh. You can see that these are the types of meshes which are using nowadays in the field. The main advantages are simplicity of its construction, lesser dead weight. That is the main thing. The dead load of the structure will be very less when compared with the normal structure due to its smaller in thickness. And it main highlighted here is high in tensile strength. Due to usage of the meshes, the high tensile strength attains maximum. Less cracks has been developed because due to that spacing between the wire meshes is very minimum, so that the cracks developed can be less with compared to the conventional concrete. And here it is easily repairability, non-corrosive in nature, and easier moldability to any required shape, so that you can roll, you can fold, anything can be used with the help of the square meshes, and that structure can be easily adapted with the help of the ferrocement. This material is more suitable to special structures like shells, which have strength through forms, and structures like roofs, silos, water tanks, and pipelines. So we can adapt it at any type of structures. So example, in the one photo we have seen that it is adapted for roof as well as wall. Can use it for the silos, water tanks even, and the pipeline structures. The pipeline structures nowadays they are doing with the help of the wire ferrocement only. The reinforcement with closely spaced wires is the most commonly used reinforcement in the ferrocement. So we will see some other photographs in the upcoming slides. In the ferrocement, a wire mesh is required to control the cracking and the skeleton steel to support the wire mesh. So that is the main thing which I discussed in the previous slide also. So the wire mesh itself acting as a steel reinforcement to control the cracking in the structure. Use of fine meshes with thin wires at closely spacing for effective crack control. So to arrest more cracks, even we can use the fine meshes with thin wires, very closely spacing. So that way, if it was very closely spacing, means that itself acting as a reinforcement here. So that will arrest the cracks up to max. Even some cases there will be no meaning of cracks developed in the ferrocement concrete. The type of wire mesh reinforcement used in the ferrocement. So these are the types: hexagonal wire mesh, square mesh, three dimensional. You can see that this is the hexagonal wire mesh. Diameter of wires varies between 0.5 mm to 10 mm. Depends on that structure. We can choose the diameter of the wire mesh. The grid size varies between again 10 mm to 25 mm. These meshes are more flexible and easier to work with it, so that any shape can be adapted with this. Any section can be adapted here. It can easily foldable, so that the type of section or the type of shape can be used here, which means we can easily take it to the desired shape. So whatever dream shape we are having, we can make a structure with the help of the hexagonal wire mesh. This is square mesh. It is made out of straight wires in both the longitudinal and the transverse direction. Thus welded mesh thickness is equal to two wire diameters. The welded meshes are weak at welded spot. That is the main disadvantage here. So at we have welded spot, it may be weak, so that it may be fail at any point. The diameter varies between 1 mm to 1.5 mm. Grid size varies between 15 to 25 mm. So the failure may appear here. Okay, which does not mean that the structure will get collapse. So it may lead to cracks. That is the point I like to mention here when they're talking about that. Weld meshes are weak at the welded spots. And this is a three-dimensional meshes, like that we have a floor mat in our house, we can see like this. The three-dimensional meshes, a crimpled keeper wire frictionally locks together three alternating layers of the straight wires. You can see here the three alternating layers. While zooming here, you can able to see it properly. The mesh is sufficiently thick so that in some application only one layer is required. So even though it is a three-dimensional, one layer is far enough in some conditions, but depends on the condition, more thickness is needed. In those cases, we can go with the three-dimensional wire mesh. The types of mortar used for the ferrocement: ordinary cement mortar, high performance mortar, lightweight aggregate mortar, fiber reinforced mortar, and polymer. So ordinary cement mortar is used to make with the help of Portland cement. The filtered material is usually a well graded sand capable of passing 2.36 mmc. So normally we are saying that a material which passes through 4.75 mm is a fine aggregate, whereas here it should be, since the thickness is very less here, so that we should take the sample which is passed over the 2.36 mmc. However, depending upon the characteristics of the reinforcing material, mortar may contain some small size gravel also. So if the requirement is high, depending upon the characteristic properties, so that small size of gravel, say example 5 mm, 6 mm gravel can be used. Maximum of 8 mm gravel can be used in this type of structure. The mixed proportion ranges of the mortar for ferrocement are sand cement ratio by weight 1.4 to 2.5, water cement ratio by weight 0.3 to 0.5. Whenever we are considering it as a weigh batching method. This next is high performance mortar. This mortar is similar to conventional cement mortar, but it contains mineral admixture to produce impermeable matrix. This enhances the durability of ferrocement by providing greater protection to the reinforcement. So name itself, high performance, so automatically it will increases the durability of the ferrocement by providing greater protection. By proper selection of chemical and mineral activities and water cement ratio, the ferrocement mortar can reduce pore size considerably and thereby achieving high strength levels, which are not possible in the conventional method. So whenever we are choosing a proper chemical and mineral admixtures as well as the materials, with respect to the water cement ratio, and that can be adapted for ferro cement. Means so the strength level will attain very maximum, that is not at all possible in case of the conventional concrete. So that's why nowadays ferro cement is highly growing, and many research work has been carried out in the ferro cement. It having compressive strength in the range of 50 to 100 megapascal. So normally in concrete, 100 megapascal means we try for more quantity of cement. Not at all achieving 100 megapascal is very tough, as well as adding cement content per m cube of concrete is 600 kg plus. Whereas here, with the help of very thin shape, we can adapt the more strength. So that is the advantage of the cement. Lightweight aggregate mortar. It is used to construct low cost housing. Lightweight aggregates reduce the density of the mortar. So low cost housing, in picnic spots they used to adopt low cost housing, or in some hotels they may have planned for temporary, so that there they can use this type of lightweight aggregate. It helps in reduction of dead load, and lightweight aggregate are introduced replacing the sand in the mortar. Lightweight aggregates reduces the normal thermal conductivity. So whenever it reduces the thermal conductivity, so that the cracks develop might be reduced, as well as the dead load. Whenever the dead load gets decreased, the quantity of materials used here will also get decreased. So example, so with the help of lightweight aggregate mortar, they have constructed like this, a small dome to pass over this. Well, this can be, if you kept a shell over the two layers and have a door, means this will be act as one room in the picnic spot. Lightweight aggregate mortar only, with this only they have made these shells. So this for again, this might be reshaped at later stages. So this is another example. Fiber reinforcement mortar composites. Fiber reinforcement mortar composites are produced by introducing small diameter discontinuous fibers during mixing of mortar matrices. So very smaller diameter fibers can be adapted. So this can be produced from steel or even carbon, glass, nylon, etc., with various shapes and sizes, so that they can pass a high modulus of elasticity, which leads to strong and stiff composites. Whenever we are adapting steel fibers, glass fibers, they place a major role in increasing the flexural strength of the property. Whenever the flexural strength increases, the strength of the structure and durability of the structure will have a maximum time period. So this is the steel fiber photo, and which can be used for the cement. And this is the glass fiber photo, which is used in the ferro cement. So this will be some addition to the cement as well as the fine aggregate. We can add these fibers to increase the strength factor. Fiber reinforcement mortar composites. Very short length of 2 mm to 12 mm were used to increase their properties. The short fibers was used in the composite with the objective of improving the crack resistance, so that the fiber, whenever we are adding the fibers, immediately the crack will be get arrested. Whenever the crack arrested, the strength and durability factors will get increased. So their major role is to control micro cracking. Even though the micro hair cracks will be there, that also can be arrested with the help of the short fibers. The long fibers were used to improve the post cracking behavior, or short fibers will used in arresting the micro cracking behavior. The length of these fibers allow them to bridge the cracks. So this cracks may be allocated throughout the length. These fibers may be framed or formed in the structure throughout its length. So this may leads to the bridge the cracks. The fibers can then transmit the loads from the cracked matrix to uncracked matrix, so that from the load transfer throughout the beam, if the cracks has been developed, the load transfer will get delayed, or it may get postponed, or it may get failure. So that this, if the presence of fibers, the fibers will transfer the load by acting as a reinforcement from top to bottom, as well as from either one side to the other side. So that is the major role of the fiber whenever the structure gets cracked, which results in the more ductility of the material. Next is polymer mortar. To overcome the disadvantage of cement mortar and concrete, such as delayed in hardening, low tensile strength, and some other factors, this polymer mortar can be adapted in case of industrial applications. This polymer modified mortar is obtained by adding a polymer material to cement mortar during resulting in polymer modified mortar. The polymer fills up the capillary pores, making the concrete more impermeable. So this polymer concrete may be most applications are boats construction, sunscreen, cylindrical shell roof, folded plate roof, water tanks. So major references we can take for the water tank as well as the folded plate roof, like dome structures, cylindrical shell roof, etc. So boat construction, this boat has been developed with the help of the polymer mortar only. Cylindrical shell roof. So the most highlighted is the curing time will also get reduced with the less thin structure. We can adapt the work in the field very easily.